Hey guys, you're welcome to this show. It's called Business and Comedy. Actually, this is the first time I'm doing something like this. But again, you all know what's going on. Okay, coronavirus has really changed our lives and system. I'm more of the Facebook guy, and I do a lot on Facebook. But I just felt that a lot of you guys wanted more conversations on Instagram. And so, you know, why not just have that? So today I'm going to be having Wole Arole, and we're going to be looking, of course, into his life. However, one of the major sectors that is changing now is the entertainment sector, right? Comedians are able to do skits. They are able to be brand ambassadors for companies. So the entertainment sector is also largely affected by this coronavirus, as well as small businesses. A lot of people are going to lose their jobs. So we're going to be looking into all of this and going to make sure it's humorous, okay? So like you, as you're joining me, tell me your name, your city, and just invite everybody in here. Get everybody to know we're live. We're here. We'd like everybody to join us, and let's have a fantastic conversation, you know, in a very humorous atmosphere. One of the reasons why I felt I wanted this to be humorous and invite comedians was because I also feel that a lot of us are emotionally traumatized. Conspiracy theories everywhere. All manner is flying around. So it would be good that at least we have some dose of fun and humor into this. So please, as you join, I need to know your name and your city. Your name and your city. Just type your name and your city. The reason why I'm asking for this, a lot of you use handles that are very unique to pronounce when it comes to Instagram. So I can see Tito's Stitches. Okay. Tito, what's your name, your city? Dimeji, your full name, your city. I can see Sale One. You see what I'm talking about? So your name and your city will go a long way. I have Godwin from Lagos. Godwin, good to see you. Abiola Daniel from Lagos. Abiola, thank you for joining, and good to see you, Abiola. Okay, as you guys are joining us, your name, your city, before my guest comes up. Okay, so let's have your name, your city, your name, your city. We also are streaming this live on Facebook and on YouTube. However, we will only be taking questions from this Instagram handle. So for all of you who have questions for Arole, we will only pick questions that comes from Instagram, not from Facebook or YouTube. So you have to, if you're watching live on Facebook now, quickly jump on the Instagram handle at Stephen Akinta on Instagram, and let's have this conversation. I have Prince Benjamin from Akure. Prince Benjamin, good to see you. I have Utuyin from Atlanta. Damilola from Lagos. Damilola, how are you today? Okay, Damilola from Lagos. So guys, we're going to have my guests join us shortly. Now, I would like you guys to feel free to ask questions. So the questions will be into, I'm going to be interviewing for about 30 minutes. And you're free to ask Arole any question that you have for him. But we'll also be going to certain types of questions that focus more on basically, how do you structure your business, your income, your career during this coronavirus? Because right now we have over 6 million job loss. Some say 11 million job loss in the US. We have a lot of job loss going on also in the UK. We have some businesses that will not open after coronavirus, and that's just the reality. And so looking at all this challenges. By the way, as you're joining, those of you who are just joining, your name, your city, please. We're just introducing ourselves. Your name, your city, your name, your city, your name, your city. As you join us, tell us your name and your city. And feel free to invite as many people to join us. Let's get everybody in here as we have a wonderful time today. I have Joe. watching from California, Reverend Joyce from California. Reverend, how are you? How is California today? Good to have you here, and thank you for joining Reverend Joe from California. I heard California and New York are the biggest heat as a result of this. Is that true? And what's going on? I hope you guys we have you guys in our prayers. We trust God all is going to be well. Kayode from Ogun State, Nigeria. Good to see you, Kayode. Thank you for joining. I appreciate your presence. I have Eric from Lagos, Nigeria. Eric, how are you? Thank you for joining us, Eric. Thank you for joining. I appreciate you. And thank you so much for joining. Also, feel free to start asking questions. What are your questions for Arole? Arole is a comedian. Emmanuel from Dubai. Emmanuel, how are you? Emmanuel was on honeymoon and got stranded. Okay, Emmanuel went to Dubai with his wife, bride, for honeymoon and got stranded in Dubai. Emmanuel, how is the honeymoon? So you have an extended honeymoon. Emmanuel from Dubai, good to see you. IBK from Ogun State, it's good to see you. Reverend Joe from California says, that's true. My city is little bit safe, but safety is of the Lord. Amen. We're trusting God for you. Muyiwa from Lagos, good to see you. Oluabami She from Abuja. Oluabami She from Abuja. Vivian from Lagos. Wow, good to see all of you, and really thank you for joining. I really appreciate your presence here. I have Bishtek from Enugu. Bishtek from Enugu, good to have you. Emmanuel says, honeymoon pro. This is like a heightened honeymoon. Honeymoon that will never end is what I call this, right? Unending honeymoon, because your honeymoon is not just ending. I have the Lady Billionaire Dollar from Abuja. Okay, this amazing woman, she's on fire. She calls herself Lady Billionaire Dollars. No joke. I have God. It says my Rwanda friend will join soon. Okay, you have a friend from Rwanda. We have people from all over the world. I know that. Akachi from Aba. How are you, Akachi? Good to have you here. Thank you all of you for joining us. I appreciate you. Two things I'd like you to do as more people are joining: your name, your city, and feel free to ask me any question, either about me, either about business, either about career, as well as questions about the guest that we are having today by the name Wole Arole. So let me give you some breakdown, for some of you may not know him. He started his comedy basically using selfie stick, right? So for me, one of the reasons why I became a huge fan of Arole for me was that I realized that, we are in a country where young people are disadvantaged, right? If you're a young person and you're in Nigeria, you really are disadvantaged. That's just the truth. A lot of things are just working against you, things that you didn't plan for. And he was one of such people. But instead of complaining, I don't know how true, you probably will confirm today by himself. At some point, I was told he went for a comedy event, and even they didn't pick him. But what did he do? Rather than complain and say, I've been trying to succeed in this comedy career, nobody likes me, nobody's picking me, he decided to use his phone. And I remember the quality of those videos then were quite, they were not that good. Because you would know that he didn't have a good phone that time. And then started this joke, with another guy called Ashiri. And then, in the prophetic way, Oshishe. And then before you know it, it went viral. Today, obviously, he's financially stable. He's been able to be a blessing to his family members and create so much opportunity for himself and several other people too. And for me, those are... because this Instagram Live is actually tag repositioning. The coronavirus will force all of us. We all have to reposition. We all have to restructure things the way we know it. Things are no longer going to be the way they were. We are in a new world. It's no longer like things are no longer the way they used to be. And we all have to brace up for this new reality that things are no longer like they used to be. And it's just the honest truth, guys. Fola Flakes from Abuja, good to see you. Fola Flakes from Abuja. David from Lagos, good to see you. Reverend Abiodun, how are you, sir? Good to see you from Port Harcourt. Endurance from Lagos, how are you, Endurance? Pelumi from Lagos, good to see you, Pelumi. Victor from Asaba, Victor, how are you? Okay, some of you have started putting in your questions. It has started coming in. Feel free, like I said, ask any question either from me or from my guest who will be joining us very soon. So one of the first questions is from Reverend Joe from California. It says, my question is, with your high volume of traveling schedule, how do you manage your family so that they don't feel your absence? You know, I'm a marriage counselor. Well, for me, I feel that I was lucky to marry a very understanding wife. If I was reading something very funny today, and I believe that statement is very true, that men actually do not marry for love or for sex. Some marry for love, but priority of marriage is usually as a result of what we call, you can call it peace, you can call it stability. You know, and I've seen a lot of young guys with that same question, where you ask them, why are you not married? You're financially stable, but you still notice these guys are not yet married. And I realized that what men look out for is peace of mind, stability, a woman that can manage the home, whether you're there, you're not there, and you can enjoy peace of mind. So for me, I got that. Number two, my wife understood what was at stake. We got married. Immediately I got married, I lost virtually everything I had. Financially, things became quite difficult. And so we all had that tough time. And both of us got to realize that, look, the finances have to be taken care of. And that there's a bigger risk when you're married and you have kids and you're not financially stable. So whatever was going to be the sacrifice, we agree we're going to do it. Now, and we agree we're going to do it early. Because one of the other challenges that people do not realize also is that the demand from your children actually is when they become teenagers. The teenage years, you must be able to give your children almost 100% attention. If you don't invest, as much as yes, the younger years are also important, but the younger years are more important from the mother's perspective. The younger years, the child needs tender love, tender care, you know, stability, focus, being able to, you know, seeing mommy and daddy in a very stable condition. But you see, the teenage years becomes when I believe the father's role becomes more stronger. Because at that point, mothers don't longer have much grip on their children like they had when they were tender, right? A mother can easily punish a 5-year-old, a 7-year-old, a 10-year-old. But by the time it's becoming 14, 15, 17, probably the child is even taller than the mother. Okay, at that point, you need the father. You need to begin to bring that toughness. You need to begin to bring that rationality. And if that's the time, and this is where most people then miss it, is that time that they are now heavily chasing money. Because guess what? The finances have grown at that time. The children are trying to enter university, so it's no longer, the bills are higher. Secondary school, the bills are higher. So you find parents even hustle more. But for me, what we are trying to do is that we hustle now that they're younger. And by the time they are older, I already have private jet. So certain trips I can do with them. They also can understand what's going on. So number one, for me, I enjoyed a very understanding wife. And she played a major role in making this happen for me. And also, we had to understand that there was priority, and that really helped. Because look at it, Reverend Joe, I'm sure you agree with me that if you look at marriages, okay, more than 80% of the challenges in marriages are financial. Reverend, do you agree with me? More than 70% of challenges in marriages are financial, right? Money issues, the husband is not able to provide, the wife is also struggling to be able to come up with whatever strategy she could to be able to feed the family. So you end up seeing that one of the biggest catastrophe for homes is actually the bills, right? So if you can walk around paying the bills, other things can always be worked around, can always be managed. Everybody can understand. If you look at our great-grandparents, many of them had more than one wife. But when you look at the stability they enjoy, many of us who are having one wife are not enjoying such. And the reason is because some of the men let go the role of also being able to provide financially, okay, and really understanding all that needs to go into that, and then put too much pressure on women. I strongly believe that women are not wired, okay, my own belief. Women are not wired, in my own belief, to go through financial stress. And it's just my belief. You can argue with me. Okay, you can argue with me again and again and again. Women are not wired to go through financial stress, in my own belief. So if you can work hard on solving that financial aspect, at least you solve almost 80% of the problem of the marriage. And you communicate, you know, you both understand what's at stake and what you're trying to do. Okay, any more question? Any more question? I'm still waiting for Arole to join us. Tori, she says, please, what's the internet provider that you use? It's so clear. It's a fiber optic cable, so that's probably why. But I advise, if you're Nigeria, you probably want to use MTN Wi-Fi. If you buy enough data from most of these telecoms, you might end up having a better connection, okay, than any other one. So that's what I would recommend. So again, feel free to ask me any question while we wait for our guests to join us very shortly. Again, this is Comedy and Business with Stephen Akintayo on Instagram, and our goal is, okay, is to be able to share, ask, you know, answer questions as it relates to business, as it relates to our comedy also, because I feel that people are emotionally disturbed this season. How many of you have seen so much emotion this season? In fact, in Italy, we are beginning to see serious suicide issues going on right now. People are beginning to get depressed. And so I also felt that's part of actually why I decided to say I'm also going to be hosting a comedian. I feel that people are losing it. Look at even the argument over 5G. And 10G, and the world is coming to an end, and a whole lot of the conspiracy theory, you can guess that people are beginning to get depressed. And I can't blame anybody for being depressed at this moment. For someone to be locked in the same apartment for months, for Italy now, this is the fourth month that they've been at home, it's just not normal. You can't go to work. You can't move around. You can't have your family members come visit you, eat food, and all of those things are no longer there. So people are getting depressed. And for me, it was one of the reasons why we need to have comedians also join us so that we can also make this quite exciting. And people can laugh and depression can be reduced. Okay, so, and then you can do better than that. Than Woli Arole, who is a prophet.
Hello, sir.
With the oil of gladness. Woli!
How are you? Sorry, I slept off. I really apologize. I've been very tired. I Jesus. Woke up and I was like, it's 3 minutes to say, God, oh, forgive me. Oh. Hey.
You slept off.
I'm telling you.
Slept off.
Like, I was just really off. How are you, sir?
I'm good. I'm great. Good to see you, and thank you for joining. I know you've been busy, and you've been doing several shows. I'm waiting for when you will host me on the show. I'm waiting for when you host me on your show, but I really appreciate doing this. The reason why I'm doing this, I just felt a lot of our people needed some humor, this is becoming emotional for a lot of people. You know, it's people are getting depressed, and it's really becoming depressing. So I just felt it's good to have that comedy feel to it. So good to have you, and thank you for joining us.
Now, Mr. Stevie, you still do a favor for me, because I'm meant to host someone on my own show by 5 o'clock. I'd already scheduled 4:30 to 5. But my time with my very good friend and brother would not be that. But I had to just, immediately I woke up, I said, respect is mutual. So I just went to wash my face, and I had to come on your live. So you need to just give me like 10, 15 minutes, I'll be back. So that we can really have some quality time of humor. But I'm going to definitely be right
No problem.
Thank you so much. You're welcome.
Okay, so Wole will be back. He just needed to freshen up, and he's going to be back to join us soon. But while we're waiting for him to come back, feel free, like I said, what are your questions, okay? And also tell us your name and the city you're joining us from. And please go get everybody in here. Invite people, tell everybody to join this broadcast. Let's get as many people as possible to join us, and let's really have a great time together on the show, okay? Let's get to invite people, and let's get everybody in to join us for the show. But feel free to start asking your question. I can see the Labi. Good to see you here. Well, this is Wole anointing your ministry. Let me see who else is here. Prince says, you are into any agriculture business apart from cashew? Yes, we invested in an agri export business. It's one of the businesses that we invested in, and so, but this year we're investing bigly. We're expanding in the next 5 years to have 10,000 hectare farm, where we're going to be from maize to rice to beans to basic stuff that people can. Because, like, one of the things you need to look at this season, guys, is that food is going to become gold. Food is going to be gold this season. Anything food will be gold this season. Food is going to be gold. Another thing that will be gold is healthcare pharmaceuticals. So anything around healthcare and pharmaceutical is going to be real-time money. Another thing that will be real-time money in this season is also anything that has to do with property, okay? So there are three major aspects, as well as technology. Technology is number four. And I want to say this, you know, to many of you, that you need to consider, actually, this season, expanding or diversifying. Because certain industry will be wiped out as a result of coronavirus. Literally wiped out. At least some for the next 6 months, some for the next 1 year, until there's a vaccine. Some of you can begin to mention some of those industries that you think may experience this. I know that, you know, certain industry will have these kind of issues. And so some of you who are into those industries need to begin to review your methodology, your strategy, how to go about things. Like I have somebody we're discussing, she's into fitness. So she coaches people, you know, she gets people to sign up, housewives and all of that. She goes to their house, engage them in fitness exercise. I had to tell her, I said, look, with what is going on now, you probably need to create an e-learning program for your fitness business, okay? And begin to get people to subscribe to latest videos in fitness as against going to their house to begin to get them to you know, do exercise, because a lot of people are afraid to get anybody into their house anymore. People ain't going to allow anybody come to their house anymore, the way things have gone. People ain't going to allow, you know, so certain industry, and you need to begin to think proactively. The mistake some of us make when it comes to some of these things is that we're waiting. How many of you can guess how long Nigerians should expect this to last? Can anybody guess? 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. Okay, can anybody guess? This lockdown, for things to return back to normal in Nigeria, can you guess how long it will take? Can anybody guess? Adebayo says vaccine is likely to be available by September. That is the earliest that there can be vaccine. Okay, that's the earliest. If you're waiting for vaccine, the earliest we can have vaccine is September. However, for the vaccine to then go global, okay, for every country to have it, you are looking at December, okay? Because when the vaccine comes out, it is the country that was able to create that vaccine that first uses it, okay? So they need to produce enough quantity for their people. If it's China, China has to be the one to use it first. If it's India, if it's USA. So before it gets to other parts of the world, it's going to take at least till December, and you need to still look at mass production. The other alternative for this is probably being able to get a cure, like the hydroxychloroquine. For us to be able to know whether hydroxychloroquine can work, is going to take another 3 months. And I think that's the best chance for this whole thing to go away in the next 3 months. And people have asked me why. I said, because we have enough chloroquine. Our pharmaceutical companies have capacity to be able to produce more chloroquine. And so if hydroxychloroquine can solve this, then it's easy for Nigerians and Nigerian businesses to get back in the next 3 months. But anything outside that, okay, do not expect things to go back to normal, at least in Nigeria, until the next 3 months. And I think this is the way everybody needs to look at what's going on here, because a lot of people are not realizing that fact. I've seen a lot of people not understanding that reality yet. I've had conversation with many people. They don't even know that this is a long, long issue. Okay, that this will take a whole while before things get to normal. It will take a whole while before everybody gets to normal. I'm telling you now. So we're looking at salaries, you know, is likely not going to be paid. We're looking at even after these 3 months, a lot of people will have lost their jobs. We're looking at the reality that most people will be holding tight to their money, so they don't want to spend money. Because they are holding tight to their money, companies won't be able to have money to pay bills, to pay salaries, because they are also not able to make money. So this is the time for everyone to begin to review whatever business you're doing. For you as a career person, I think one of these you want to look at is called freelancing. Okay? Can everybody type freelancing? Come on, everybody type freelancing. You want to look at freelancing opportunities. In the case where your business can do that. So how can you begin to provide services for people on a virtual level? If you're a writer, can you sign up on website like Fiverr.com, Upworks.com, and several of these various websites, and begin to offer services for people to write for them, to proofread, to edit? If you're a video editor, can you begin to look for, you know, global brands that you can begin to do? But we are getting to a point where everybody needs to begin to, I'm talking of career people now, I've talked about businesses. Businesses need to begin to look at these four areas. How can your business render services in the technological space, render services or use technology to deliver your services, or food or agriculture industry, or pharmaceutical healthcare industry, or real estate industry? that is areas you need to begin to think of now. However, if you're a career person, you have a job, do not expect that your salary will be waiting for you at the end of the month. And do not expect that you have bills. Food items are going to keep increasing. Bills are going to keep increasing. You need money and you need to wake up. You know, let me say this, and this is very important. 5% of people know that, you know, make things happen in this world. Only 5% of people make things happen in this world. Only 5% of people make things happen. Again, we have 25% of people who know things are happening, but they are not the one making it to happen. Okay? And then what happened? You now have 70% of people who do not know that anything is happening. And that's the reality of the world as it is now. So what we're saying now, people are not even, you know, I was chatting with somebody who was saying, oh, in the next 1 week, they will open Nigeria. And I just laughed. I said, are you kidding me? They will relax and then tighten, relax and tighten and relax and tighten. But nothing will happen in the next 3 months. That's the reality. Okay? So what is happening is, what's happening in reality is that we're in for a long haul, but most people don't know. We're in for a long haul, but most people don't know. And most people are not restructuring their lives, their income to suit this new reality. Most people are not. We're not facing the fact that we need to begin restructure. You need to spend less of your money if you're an employee. You need to begin to look at a virtual service you can provide, like freelancing, like I've mentioned. Now, the question some of you will ask me is that what if I do not have a skill in the freelancing area? So when we say freelancing, we're looking at web design, graphics, accounting, legal services, and so on and so forth. Coaching, consulting. As long as it's something you can offer people virtually and the world needs it, you can be a freelancer and you can be making money from anywhere in the world. I've given you some websites you can go to. However, if what's your current skill, you're afraid that freelancing may not be what can help you make money, what you want to then do is to go learn a new skill. Go learn a new skill. So one of the skills that you must learn now is how to sell. I don't care who you are, all of you who have always hated selling. The only people that will guarantee pay, that will get money at the end of every month, no matter what, are those who can sell. Let me repeat myself again. The only people that are guaranteed to be able to get paid will be those who can sell. So if you hate selling before, this is the time to begin to go look for video courses, training, coaching program on selling. Because, for example, if your boss refused to pay your salary because they're also not making money, what do you then need to do? Look for companies that are still providing services, e.g. e-commerce. People need groceries delivered to their house. Jumia, some e-commerce companies are beginning to deliver food to people's houses, right? Those companies have affiliate links. You can become the affiliate and begin to promote that, hey, guys, do you know you can buy your food item and Jumia will deliver it to your house, for example. And as anybody who buys from Jumia, you get a commission on every transaction that is done. That way you begin to make money. At least Jumia will credit your account. So look for companies that are still able to make money in this season and use your selling skill to be able to help those companies to make money. And I promise you, they will for sure be able to still credit you. You'll still be able to get something to the table. Now, if you also have a business and your business is currently in a situation where you can no longer at this point, the kind of business you run, you will not be able to make money, okay, from your kind of business. For example, if you run a restaurant, all restaurants are shut down, right? So if you run a restaurant, The reality right now is that the restaurant cannot, okay? The restaurant cannot open. So what do you want to do? Look for, and the same thing with the gymnast that I talked to you about. One of the advantages she has is that she has network of a lot of, most of the, anybody who will be able to hire a private gym has some money. So she could, for example, partner with a real estate company and begin to talk to all her former clients and say, hey, there are proper real estate investment you can do. They are doing discount. They are doing this or any other thing. So any high net worth product, she could begin to sell and get a commission. The same thing for anybody who is doing a business, and your business will no longer make money as a result of coronavirus. What do you want to do? Begin to look for companies that are still making money during coronavirus. Partner with those companies and get a cut. One of those businesses is the telecoms. As we speak right now, people are still making money from the telecoms. So people are still making money. The telecoms are making good money. You can see how people are struggling with internet, okay? But because the telecoms are even overwhelmed right now. A lot of people are now using data, using the calls, they are calling, they are making money, okay? Or helping people to buy data, helping people to buy a recharge card in a virtual way, okay? The cable companies are also making money right now. So DSTV, GoTV, Star Times. So can you make money? One of the businesses I teach is recharge and bill business, okay? Where, you know, you can own a website to begin to provide services for people. So right now, I'm able to make money in that particular business. People are able to go to my website. They're able to buy data, buy airtime. They're able to pay for their DSTV. They're able to recharging their phone as well as even cable network. Because people are bored. This is the time nobody not want to renew their cable services. Because they just want to watch TV. It's just too boring. Somebody is asking, says, by the way, please feel free to ask me questions, guys. Questions. Feel free to ask me any question. This is Business and Comedy with Stephen Akintayo. And my guest today is Arole. Arole joined earlier and said, we should give him 10 minutes. He's going to join us back. Okay. So, I don't know, it declined, but let me invite him again. But what I was asking earlier, can you all hear me?
We don't hear you the other time, but now I can hear you.
You can hear me, Abby?
Yeah, I can hear you. I can hear you. I'm sure it's network.
Yes, beautiful. So let's go on. So the question was, how are you repositioning now? Yes, go ahead.
So the thing about it is, like I said, for me, I'm beyond a comedian. For me, I can speak for myself. I'm a social media influencer. I'm into movies. I'm an actor. I'm a business person. So there are a couple of things that there's a lot of time behind. So moments like this, and the thing about it, once you have a community of people, wherever there is number, there is money, irrespective of what is going on. Okay, let's, for example, you're calling me on this show. You can tell me I really do this stuff for me. I have a show that is going on. A lot of people are watching it. Brands are going to come on. So I feel that the only time when there is no money is when there is no idea, wherever you are, all over the world. Okay. In this period of corona, people are making a lot of money. A whole lot of money.
Yeah.
You know, people are not even moving and eating and that. So where you see people, there is money. Where there is idea, there is money. So that.
Yeah, the formula is people equals money. You know, you started this revolution of comedians using selfie stick, you know. You started that whole. What led to that? Where were you before you went viral with the concept of using selfie stick to do comedy? Where were you, and how did that just change the game? Because a lot of people now copy that model, you know. But you pioneered it.
For me, I was in the university when I started. You know. I was in OAU and everything. So I started that stuff. I just woke up one morning. I just like my phone, just like we're talking. I did a first video. People loved it and I continue to do it. And I must say that the thing about ideas is, ideas just come to us. I feel like there's God's way of communicating to humans.
Yeah.
So when it drops it, it's just left for you to move with it. His own is to drop it. Okay, look at G-Tech. I'm sure it was an idea from God. Look at G-Tech path. Yeah. Look at all the things you're doing. So for me, doing of skits, it came as an idea. And I just had it one morning with my friend, carried the phone, call me, sir. And, you know, from there, we started evolving, we started learning, we started upgrading, and this is where we are today.
Fantastic. But, you know. Guys, you can type whatever question you have for Wole Arole, as well as you can also type which of his comedy skits is your favorite. I think the Ogo 5G, Ogo 7G, Ogo 10G was also probably something that I think people resonated with a lot.
Yeah, because of the university thing.
Yeah.
People are very personal with their schools.
So, Wole Arole, are you married? If you're not married, what are you
doing? Don't care. man of God. Man of God. I'm not.
Yes. No,
if I have a deputy, no, I'm not. I'm very, very on my.
So, why? What are you waiting for?
God will. I knew you were going to bring me on the phone, and I don't trust you, Mr. I don't trust you. But I believe when the right person comes and everything is going to work out, you know.
Okay, so right person, if you are here, send him a DM. You know, if you think you are the right person, send Wole Arole a DM. And if your Ogo is 5G, Ogo 5G, nan soba ilolo. Of all the conspiracy theories out there, which one do you believe in, and which one is the most ridiculous for you?
The most ridiculous for me is that. This man, that's why people that have sense like this man just bring and just put you on the spot. The most ridiculous for me is that you cannot start local and become global. Yeah.
Okay.
It's a big myth. You can start local and become very global. And I'm an example of that. Yeah, it's a big myth. It's not true.
Okay. So what I'm saying is that the conspiracy theories as a result of coronavirus, we have the conspiracy theory of 5G caused coronavirus. We have conspiracy theory of they want to put chip in human beings. We have conspiracy theory of, I mean, a lot is going on now. I mean, we don't even know which one we should believe in. So of all this, which one do you believe in that could have led to this coronavirus? And which one is ridiculous for you? Like, why, for example, people said, 5G was how coronavirus started. Is that a conspiracy theory you believed in?
Okay, sir. Steven, my spirit told me, you that I know, sense will not kill you there. But sense, no finish. So for me, the thing about me, I love to share a lot of knowledge on what I have. I'm sure about.
Yes.
So, because there are some things I'm still really researching about, I don't have clarity about it. But for me, on Corona, I know it's real. I know that if you are not careful, it can be caught. I know that it's a virus. I know it started from China.
Okay.
You get my point. In the city in China. So a lot of people have been saying it's a biological warfare. It's not a biological warfare. China is this, China is that. I don't have full grasp on it. So I'm careful not to say this is that. Yeah. You know, I ascertain what I have to say when I am sure of what I'm know when I've researched on it, because I'm a voice. So just I really said it. So I'm very careful.
Yeah.
And the 5G is another advancement after the 4G.
Mm.
Okay, the science behind it, why they are doing it, I don't know yet. But you know, some. So, because the thing about it is that words are very powerful. You know, somebody, yes. You know, that's why the pastor will say something today and come the next time and say, this is not what it is. After research.
Mm-hmm.
So something, the thing that's happening to us is just becoming very new. It's becoming very fresh. So for me, Corona is real. We should stay safe, wash our hands, sanitize. The 5D thing, let's see how it goes first. Let's see. I remember at the time, some people say, what technology was in laptop? Was, you know, some people were saying, no, the television is not this. Now they're using the TV. So for me, I think it's an evolution. Gradual. Yeah. So let's have
Beautiful. I have Tony here from UK. She has a question for you. So what advice would you, Arole, give to those abroad to do in the area of business?
My advice is when it comes to business, business is a very, very careful place where one must be careful. But for those abroad, I feel that investment is very major, is key. Thank God for someone like you that you're in a lot of properties and all of that. It's good to invest. Sit down well on what you really, 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 really want to do with the business. Be convinced it down. Read about it, research about it, and you'll be really fine.
Okay, fantastic. Another person says, I heard the world is going to end on the 12th, which is tomorrow. As
a I don't know about that. Prophet,
what do you say?
I mean, I've not seen anything about that.
You did not see anything about that.
At all.
So we'll go with the prophet. Prophet says the world will end tomorrow. So relax.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'll just say one more question because I still have some things to really do. Planning for another show again. So.
Yes, one more question. It says, Prince says, Wori Arole says, it says, who advised you to attend Met Film School?
Oh, so my Met Film School thing, I attended it because I just wanted to learn more, to know more. You know, it's my passion. So I searched, I want to be beyond just a skit maker. You know, I want to be beyond that guy that you see. And one of the ways to enter another level is to learn. You know, I know you've also gone for a lot of lectures, let's say, into our business and all of that. So what informed that for me was a quest for self-development, and that's it.
Fantastic. What's your final words to everybody all over the world, your fans, your lovers, people? One advice that is spiritual, another as relates to their business or their income, or their career, but people will lose jobs this season and things like that.
So, but my advice is first, just know this too will pass. Corona won't be around for all over. No, Corona will end. It's a pandemic. A lot of pandemic come, and even World War ended. So it's going to end. I want to tell everybody, be happy. I know it's really hard for people to be happy at this time. People are depressed. Just hope everything is gonna be fine. Don't joke with relationship with people at this time. Check on people. People are going through a lot. And spiritually, please stay connected to God. I beg of you, this is a time of a deeper reflection of your walk with God. This too will pass and everything will be fine. And I must say, I really respect this man called Stephen Akintayo. You're a man I respect, you're a man I value. And that's why I can share my brand with yours. You're doing an amazing, absolute job.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it. I really do. We all love you. We love what you're doing. You are somebody I really celebrate what God is using to do. And please keep up. I love your move on doing a lot of skits. And I've seen some of the people you are hosting. Good content. We need a lot of more positive content that can calm people down, that can get people hope, give people hope. Thank you for coming. Can we all appreciate Wole Arole, everybody? Come on, let's celebrate.
Thank you.
Love you. Thank you for coming. God bless. Okay, guys. So that's it with Arole. I hope you enjoyed that interview. Any final question for me as, you know, based on what we've shared so far, business-wise? We've shared a lot today, even though it was divided into two. So for those of you who join later, go watch the part one. We talked about some of the businesses you should begin to consider to do if you're an employee. We talked about the type of business you should consider opportunities you think of right now, considering what's going on. We talked also, if you are a business owner, your business is shut down, what you should consider doing right now. Feel free to follow this handle at Stephen Akintayo. On Tuesday, we're going to continue this series. I'm going to be having MC Abe and a very successful entrepreneur by the name Tope Rushewe, who is going to be joining us next week, Tuesday. And then on Wednesday, we're going to be having Holy Malam, as well as another great consultant, management consultant. His name is Izuwama. And we're still going to be having more people join us, comedian, entrepreneurs. That's why we target business and comedy, just to give positive content out there and keep everybody excited and with positivity. Again, I want to say a big thank you to all of you who have watched this. Yes, Instagram records this. You can always download this. I think there's an app to download this video and watch it again and all that. So feel free to share this across to your friends to watch. I love you all, and I appreciate you all for coming. Don't forget to join me again on Tuesday and on Wednesday, okay, for the subsequent episode. Love you. Bye-bye. Yeah, don't forget, go subscribe to my YouTube channel. We're going to be putting this video on the YouTube channel, Stephen Akintayo TV on YouTube, at Stephen Akintayo TV on YouTube. You're going to get a lot of that value there at Stephen Akintayo TV, okay? Go get the value there. Subscribe to it. Subscribe to the channel. There's always positive content that I always give there. I love all of you. Love you. Bye-bye. See you on Tuesday.